Hello everyone, today I'll be showing you two different methods of adding references in Word. The first method will be copying and pasting references from Google Scholar, and the second method will be using references option in Word in order to add citations and automated references on bibliography. Okay, let's get started. Here we already have a citation, but we don't have its full reference, okay? We need to find its full reference in Google Scholar. Good. Let's go to Google Scholar. Type Google Scholar. Okay. So we use the site scholar.google.com. So our Google Scholar that we are going to use this one. So we are going to copy this one and its keywords is urban growth. Okay. We'll copy, we'll paste this one. So as we have said, its keyword is urban growth. We just click on this one. So we just click on these quotations. Okay, so here we see different reference style, but we are going to use API style. I just copy. We paste here. Okay, for the second paragraph we don't have citation. Okay, we just copy this paragraph. Okay, and paste it in Google Scholar. We just delete this one. Okay, here you can choose whatever citation you need or reference you need. Let's choose this one, API style. We just paste here. We do the same for third paragraph. We just copy, just delete this one and paste the third paragraph. Okay, here you can choose whatever you want. Let's choose this one. Okay, paste and copy. And paste. So we need to find our in-text reference or citation. Okay, here we need to come here, pop this on. First, we just add parentheses, and here parentheses, just delete this one, even. Okay, we just add to the summary. So let's continue with the third paragraph. We just copy this one and paste it here. So add parentheses, we just delete here, up to here. Okay, so we finish adding citations for the first method. Okay, let's finish the first method by arranging references in alphabetic way, Okay, we'll select all and come to home from A to Z. Okay. So you need to know that each difference here is a paragraph. Okay, ascending, good. Yes, is a paragraph. Okay, as you see here, we have N, we have O, we have P. Good. So we finish the first method, but I recommend you to use the second method, because for the second method, all the citations will be automatic and all the reference lists will be automatic too. Okay, so let me show you how to do it. You copy this one and let's paste it here. Here you can keep watching it and come to references, insert citation, add a new source. So you need to know, is this a journal or is this a book? Okay, you need to know it. So here you'll be using this dissertation guideline writing. Okay, where you can see whether is a journal, or here we have a journal paper article. Okay, RE 10%. Also here we have a reference of a book. Okay, but according to the examples here of a journal, you may find this one is a journal. Okay, we just paste it here. Here we have pages. You will cut these pages, cut pages, paste here. Here we have volume. You cut this volume, show all bibliography. Come here to volume, paste, and we have issue number is 2. Okay, issue number is 2. And look for journal name. Our journal name is this. Again, you cut and paste here. Okay, let's look for our title. Our title is this one. We also cut and paste. Okay, we look for our year. We also cut and paste here. Here we don't need this parenthesis. Okay, so as long as we have one offer, we don't need to edit. Okay, let's click OK. So this is our automatic in-text reference. Okay, it means we'll just delete this first method. So this second one, sorry, the second one is more profitable. Okay, we use this, the second one, which is automatic. Okay, let's continue with the second example for you to understand well the second method. Okay, let's continue with this. Okay, let's continue with the example of this second reference. We just copy this one. Okay, and maybe let's paste it here and come also to add new source. So we need to know, is this a journal or is this a book? Okay, according to this citation guideline, so you'll find that this one is also a journal. Okay, we just paste it here. We need to look for pages. Just paste them here. So we have a volume 40 and issue 4. Okay, let's cut. Come here, show all bibliography. Volume is 40 and issue 4. Okay, let's look for journal name. Again, our journal name must be italic. Okay, as you see here, our journal name is italic. Okay, it means we'll choose this one. Just let's cut. Let's test here. Let's also cut our title. Let's paste it here. And let's look for our year. Cut. Paste. Okay, we also have one upper. So we don't need to edit. Okay, we just click. Okay. So it means I want to delete this one. I also to delete this first method. Okay, yeah, I'm going to use second method. This one is very professional. Okay, so I hope you have understood. This one is very professional. Also, we can bring about our automated references. Okay, to do so, let's escape. We will come here to bibliography. Okay, and then we'll come to references. You'll see that our references here are automatic. Okay, are automatic. Okay, we just only give the same format, times New Roman 12. Okay, we just justify our document 1.5. So it means here better you can use the second method. Okay, this one is more professional. Okay, this one is automatic. Yeah, you can change its color. Okay, so let me wish you all the best and thank you for watching. If you have any question, do not hesitate to ask. Okay, this one is automatic as you see. So I do recommend you to use the second method. Thank you.